Kauk, and Jim Bartels. Together, we'll provide the commentary for tonight's action. And the great moments continue as we take a look at the finalists in this 1987 Minnesota State High School Wrestling Tournament. In Class A at 98, Brad Dandurand of Clarkfield and Jeff Sterriker of Staples. And in Double A, Jim Gail from Totino-Grace and Roosevelt's Jerry Martin meet at 98. At 105, Maple Lake's Lenny Wurm faces Oakley Plummer's Todd Bergeron, and Fridley's Troy Melton meets Matt Bezik of New Prague. Two undefeated wrestlers at 112 pounds in Class A, Rick Garner of Cannon Falls and Corey Bennett from Clarissa. Another New Prague wrestler, Brian Westerlin, challenges Tom Menny from Forest Lake in Double A. Janesville's Ted Jewison challenges Battle Lake Underwood senior Mike Morgan at 119. In AA, it's North versus South. Rochester Mayo's undefeated senior Todd Anger faces Virginia senior John Hakala. It will be Chris Pressler from Bruton and LeCenter's Joe Block at 126. And Ed Kelm, a junior from Shakopee, meets Columbia Heights senior Dane Barrett. At 132, Pat Lawrenson from Greenbush faces Jim Boyskins from Belle Plaine. And in 2A, it's a dream match. Osseo Steve Icano and Grand Rapids senior Joe Seeger. Maple Lake's Mark Anderson and Madison's David Haas vie for top honors in Class A, while Roosevelt's Dana Crone and Simley's Derek Jones lock horns in 2A. In the 145-pound division, Corey Olson of Hayfield and Chad Bodine of Montevideo Maynard meet in Class A. And in AA, it's Tim Tusenat of Faribault and David Grossum from Mankato West High School. Canby's Rusty Cockerman battles Arlington Green Isle's Darren Kane in Class A. In AA, Anoka's Mark Miley will go for back-to-back state titles against St. Francis senior Tom Kerpak. Scoring off at 167 pounds, Corey Mead of Plainview Elgin Millville and Maple Lake's Peter Fouquet. And in 2A, it's Jason Skapiak from Apple Valley and Craig Cannery from Northfield. In the 185-pound division, Perham's Kyle Neitzert meets Brad Gibson from Chocayo, Alberta, Clinton Graceville in Class A, while Simley's Chris Short puts his undefeated record on the line against Virginia's Dan Kilbane. And at heavyweight, Grand Meadow Leroy Ostrander senior Chris Nelson battles Watertown Mayor senior Tim Schrupp. And in AA, it's Jeff Zeeball of Richfield and Kerry Tribbett of Grand Rapids. That's quite an impressive list of wrestlers. Here's an impressive wrestler, Mike Hauk, a world Greco-Roman champion who will be refining our color commentary tonight. And Mike, boy, we're going to see some great wrestling tonight.
Yeah, we sure are. After seeing that impressive rundown of wrestlers, I think it's going to be an exciting night. These men have worked hard for a year. They've worked hard their whole high school careers, and it's all coming down now to one match. And you know, you can bet that the adrenaline's running high, the emotions are running high, and we're going to see some great wrestling tonight.
Of course, Mike, adding to that adrenaline is the 10,000 or so fans that'll be here at the St. Paul Civic Center. Jim Bartels is going to be right down on the floor in the middle of that action. Right now, Jim is standing by with the executive director of the Minnesota State High School League, Orv Bies.
Orv Bies, executive director of the Minnesota State High School League, another outstanding Minnesota wrestling tournament. Ours is the largest in the country.
Well, it sure is, and thank you, Jim. It grows every year. This is the biggest and best one ever. We're really excited about it, and it all happens because of a lot of teamwork. The high school league staff, a great building, guillotine, the Wrestling Coaches Association, just almost 100 volunteers to put this thing on. It's just a great experience, and here we are in this 50th anniversary. We're going to add a new dimension by having the individual finals on television. Thanks to Sports Production Incorporated.
We're glad to be here. Now back to Jim.
Thanks, Jim, and we'll be looking forward to your interviews with tonight's new champions. And we'll be back with action as the 1987 Minnesota State High School Wrestling Individual Championships continue.
Start a business of their own, a business run for and by people who live and work right here in the country. It's called cooperating. Turns out, it's still a real good idea.
I guess compared to most, my business is pretty small potatoes. But there's nothing small about what I expect from my suppliers. When I need fertilizer and chemicals, I want what was promised, when and where it was promised. Which is why I'm happy that Cenex and Land O'Lakes are working together now. A supplier like that should be able to meet my demands. See, the co-op and I have always done business according to the law of supply and demand. I demand they supply.
The 98-pound finalists are Brad Dandurand of Clarkfield, 34-0 on the season. He's a senior. Dandurand defeated Chad Radenbaugh of St. James in the semifinals by a score of 5-0. And he'll be facing Jeff Sterriker of Staples, a junior, 34-0. Jeff in the semifinals defeated Mike Peterson of Plainview by a score of 8-4. Sterriker also had a brother who is a two-time state champion for Staples.
Live from the St. Paul Civic Center, the 1987 Minnesota State High School Wrestling Individual Championships. Our feature match, Brad Dandurand from Clarkfield and Jeff Sterriker from Staples, both coming to tonight's match with a 34-0-0 record, Mike Houck. And it's really unfortunate that one of these wrestlers will have to end their season with a loss, but that's the way it is.
That's right. That is the way it is. And I think we'll see a great match here. These guys have never wrestled before, and both undefeated, and both rip-a-raring, ready to go.
Now we see action on the A mat. Sterriker from Staples. Dandurand from Clarkfield. Staples with the maroon singlet on, the Clarkfield wrestler in the red. They break action early there, Mike.
Yeah, referee signaling a potentially dangerous situation there. Sterriker out to an early lead here. That means so much. It's good for his confidence to be able to settle down a little bit now and go to work. Pressure's on Brad Dandurand here to really come back, fight out of there. And he's working hard underneath. Sterriker is doing a good job riding. He's got a cradle there. He's looking for... Ref can call this as a potentially dangerous, maybe, if he comes up with it, with that leg hook.
Reminder, 3 2-minute periods in Minnesota State High School Wrestling. Now they stop it.
Referee there was signaling a stalemate. That's when the wrestler's getting in a position where there's no action happening. The action doesn't seem to be going anyplace. Referee will call a stalemate, blow the whistle, give him a fresh start.
And it's really up to the wrestler who's in control to make things happen.
That's right. That's right.
Right now, that's Staples' Jeff Sterriker. Minute to go in this first period, just underway. From the St. Paul Civic Center.
Jeff doing a good job there riding. Referee again, potentially dangerous. But Jeff's doing a good job keeping that pressure on. He's breaking down the hips. He was riding with a move called an arm bar there. He's looking for a turn, going for some back points, and hopefully going for a fall.
Most of this first period, it's been the Staples wrestler in control. It's a fine wrestling tradition at Staples with head coach Don Dravis.
Nice escape. Nice quick little sit-out escape by Brad Dandurand.
Two to one now. Sterriker in the lead.
Again, referee signals a stalemate, gives him a fresh start.
Sometimes it's got to be tough to be the first ones out there, Mike, to kind of break in the crowd.
Yeah, it sure is. It sure is. And guys, I'm sure, are a little nervous, and maybe even now they're wrestling a little nervous. But I think as the match goes on, they tend to loosen up a little bit, and they'll get some action going here. Both men doing a good job.
Coming down to the closing phases of this first period.
Really, at this point right now, it's anybody's match. Todd's out, or Jeff's out to an early start, but two more periods to go. Anything can happen yet.
2-1, the Staples wrestler in the lead, Jeff Sterriker, a junior, leading Brad Dandurand, a senior, out of Clarkfield High School. Two minutes, and now is when it's been a long tournament. The Staples wrestler having to wrestle
nice
team
reversal
as well, and it just proves that he's in excellent shape here.
That's right. That's right. And that was a super reversal there. And again, Jeff's on top. Looks like he's in good control. He's got that wrist. I think Brad doesn't like that position there. He's having some problems. Jeff just keeps working the arms. Now he's working a cross face. Whoop. Maybe a little high. Nice recovery.
Now Sterriker with a 4-1 lead over Dandurand.
Referee signals one there for an escape. Brad, nice.
Turned him over, but they had called a stalemate just prior to that. Stop the action, wrestlers back up to their feet. And now a stoppage here for Sterriker, as he has developed a cut above his eye, it looks, and his coach is gonna come out to inspect that. The stoppage in the A division, let's move our cameras over to the AA division where Jerry Martin from Minneapolis Roosevelt and Jim Gale from Totino-Grace are going at it. And Mike, this is a repeat of the Region 5 AA championship. These two battled it out for the region championship. And oddly enough, it just proves they were the best two wrestlers in the state at this division. They meet in the state champions.
Anything can happen still. It's a new match, a fresh match.
We pick up the action with 30 seconds to go in the second period. The Roosevelt wrestler, Jerry Martin, in the lead. Now let's go back over to single A competition where Jeff Sterriker has been repaired and he's back on the mat again. 55 seconds to go in the second period. He still holds on to a 4-2 lead over Clarkfield's Brad Dandurand. And thus far, it's been Sterriker who's been making things happen.
Yeah, Sterriker definitely looks like he's controlling this match. Brad's 2 points were on escapes. Sterriker seems to be controlling on the feet.
His coach Dravis didn't like that call at all as they bring him to the middle.
Yeah, he must have felt Jeff had good position, good control there. Brad here working a tie-up on that head, hoping to create some action, try to get a little takedown, but Jeff doing a good job there defensively.
Time running down here in the second period, and Sterriker holding on to a 4-2 lead. Neither wrestler able to score any near fall points quite yet.
I think these two men are quite evenly matched here. And I think in a situation where you have two men that are evenly matched, two tough competitors, a lot of times you don't see a lot of the big points. You see the 1 point escapes, 2 point takedowns, tough riding, tough control wrestling. But believe me, both of these men are working extremely hard out there.
Well, 2 minutes of wrestling to go. The final 2 minutes of the season for these two. And now it's up to Clarkfield's Brad Dandurand to come up with something to score. He's down 4-2 to Staples' Jeff Sterriker.
Right. Brad definitely here needs to get something going. It's the last period. He's down by two. And looks like he's trying to control that arm, go behind. But he needs to score here.
Certain that the Staples wrestler wants to score as well to pad his lead.
That's right. That's right. Notice Jeff Sterriker here is working type of a cradle. Staples has been known through the years for cradles. They teach cradles, they do cradles up there very well, and Jeff here doing a type of a cradle, and he's got it. It looks like no points yet. There you go, 2 points.
He's got plenty of time to go in this third period, still a minute and 10 seconds to go.
That's right, in very good position here. No back points as of yet, but he did get another takedown.
6-2 now, Sterriker in the lead.
Referee signals potentially dangerous.
As they get up in the neck area, that's when the referees keep a keen eye on the action.
That's right. Looks like there was a point there. I think it was some type of an illegal hold, it must have been.
So at a point for Dandurand, 6-3 the score. We have a minute to go in the match. See Coach Jim Williams over there cheering on his wrestler. Sometimes it's hard to hear anyone talk in this arena with 10,000 screaming fans, but the coaches right at mat side have the best advice.
Yeah, that's right. You wonder sometimes if the wrestlers are hearing them, but they definitely have good advice. Match is winding down here. Again, looks like Sterriker's in control.
30 seconds to go. They call a stalemate. Bring him to their feet. Dandurand needs a takedown here. Down by 3 points. 6-3.
Sterriker again. He's looking for some type of a setup. I think he's looking for that cradle again. Nice attempt at a roll. If he gets it, it could make the difference.
No points awarded yet, Mike. Dandurand working hard inside of 10 seconds to go in the match.
Nice attempt. Oh, Sterriker back. Quick little headlock again. No points. No control.
Well, a nice flurry by Brad Dandurand at the end, but Staples' Jeff Sterriker holds on to win the Class A 98-pound division. 6-3 the score. That's it for 98, and we'll be back with more wrestling from the St. Paul Civic Center in just a moment.
I'm Marty Stauffer. If there's one wild animal that knows how to have a good time, it's this one. The lakes and streams of New York State make an ideal playground for otters of the Adirondacks. Fun and games are the order of the day as a pair of river otters raises their young in one of America's largest and most beautiful wilderness parks. Next on Wild America.
Jim Skelly and Mike Houck back at the St. Paul Civic Center. Jim Bartels has a special interview lined up. Let's go over to Jim.
Thank you very much. Jeff Sterriker won the state championship at 98 pounds. Jeff, the third state championship, and your family, your brother Bob, had won a couple of times. How's it feel for family-wise right now? I'm sure a lot of pride.
Oh, it's just great.
What about the match? You took an early lead, you held the lead, but you never were able to walk away with it. What was the tempo like?
I wanted to control the match good, and I wanted to score as many points as I could. He's a tough kid, and I just wanted to control the match and stay ahead and try to score points.
And you did the job. Coach Don Dravis is with us here. Don, of course, is kind of a legend in coaching in Minnesota. You've had a lot of team champions, a lot of individual champions. I'm sure you're proud of Jeff right now.
I'm real proud. We've had kind of a drought of state champions, and now, by golly, we got another one, so maybe we can start bringing a string together again.
All right, real good. Tell you what, Jeff, congratulations once again on winning the state.
Thank you very much.
We'll be back with more from the Minnesota State High School Wrestling Tournament coming up right after these words.
When it comes to...
Hi, I'm Margaret Richard, and I'd like you to join me and all of our dancers for Body Electric right here on Pioneer Public TV. Have a great workout and a great time weekdays at 9:30 a.m. and 5:30 p.m. Join thousands of other public television viewers who shape up and slim down with Body Electric. Body Electric.
Once upon a time, a boy named Urashima rescued a sea turtle and set it free. He was rewarded with a magical visit to the kingdom of the sea, and the turtle became a symbol of good luck and long life. But the real life story of Japan's sea turtles may not end happily ever after. Can conservationists save them?
Came into this tournament as a returning state champion, but who was beaten out and is competing for third place. Wurm will be taking on Todd Bergeron of Oakley Plummer, a senior, 35-0 on the season, and a returning state champion having moved up from 98 pounds from 1 year ago. Bergeron in the semifinals defeated Scott Fernholz of Madison by a score of 9-4.
Jim Skelly and Mike Houck back with live wrestling from the St. Paul Civic Center in this 1987 State Individual Wrestling Championships. Report the champion of the 98-pound division for Class AA, Jerry Martin from Minneapolis Roosevelt, defeated Jim Gale from Totino-Grace 5-2 to win that title. So hats off to the Roosevelt wrestler, Jerry Martin. He finishes his season at 19-4-1. Gale finishes, that was his only loss of the season, 26-1-1. Gale being the third place winner. He won third place in the state championships last year at 98 pounds. Our feature match at 105 pounds, Lenny Wurm and Todd Bergeron. Wurm from Maple Lake wearing the green, Bergeron from Oakley Plummer, and the red with the white and black stripes, both undefeated wrestlers. Lenny Wurm at 33-0-0, Bergeron 35-0 without a loss. So much like the first match that we saw here tonight, a couple of undefeated wrestlers going at it, and Bergeron, the returning state champion, at 98 pounds from last year. He hasn't lost a match in 2 years. It's going to be tough, Mike.
Yeah, I think so. Another tough match. Guys off to a pretty good start here. They look quite fired up. All that nervous energy right away. They start a little quick, a little jittery, but they'll settle down in a few seconds here.
How important is it in a championship match like this to be the wrestler to make the first score?
Very important. You know, to make the first score, it's a good confidence builder. It takes the pressure off a little bit, and it sends a signal to the other wrestler that you're in control, and you've already proved yourself in the match. You know you can score on them, and so that's very important. Very important to get that first score. Right now, the men tying up there and bouncing around a little bit, looking for an opening to shoot a takedown. There's an attempt.
Action in this first period, 50 seconds to go. Lenny Wurm, the younger brother of Maple Lake senior Lloyd Wurm, the defending
nice
state champion at 132 pounds, is Bergeron.
Nice takedown. Todd Bergeron out to a lead there, 2-point takedown. Did a quick little shuck with the arm and spun behind. Looks like we've got another bloody nose. Very common injury in wrestling.
We'll wipe up the mat, and with free flow of blood, the wrestler gets an unlimited amount of time to make sure that the stoppage is made of the blood and return to action. It should be a cut or a nosebleed. He just has his at his own leisure to get back. And let's go over to AA action, where Fridley's Troy Melton and Matt Biesick
Fridley
from
in
New
trouble.
Prague are going at it.
Fridley in trouble on his back.
Biesick with a 2-0 lead over Melton. Adds another three. He's up 5-0. Let's go back to our feature match in Class A. Lenny Wurm and Todd Bergeron. Once again, Wurm from Maple Lake in the green singlet. Defending state champion Todd Bergeron from Oakley Plummer in the red.
Lenny out for an escape.
1 point for Wurm. 2-1 the score now. Bergeron in the lead. Coming down to the final seconds of this first period. Neither wrestler able to get anything going. So the final score, or the score after one period rather, Bergeron holding on to a 2-1 lead. And I just wonder what kind of effect this will have on the defending champion Bergeron with the cotton blocking the nasal passage. May affect his breathing out there on the mat tonight.
It could a little bit. The adrenaline's probably flowing, and he's
Let's go over to double-A action. Matt Biesick from New Prague leading 5-0 over Fridley's Troy Melton. It's been a dry spell for Fridley the last couple of years with getting wrestlers into the final. And Sven Erlinson from Fridley was the last one in there. Sven now at the West Point Academy.
Potentially dangerous.
59 seconds to go in the second period of that match. This B6 a tough cookie. Finished fourth in state last year in the 98-pound division, losing to Totino-Grace's Jim Gail in that third-place match. Melton working for the takedown.
Nice return to the mat there. Doing a good job of keeping that pressure on the hip.
5-0, Biesick in the lead. We'll switch back to A competition. 2-1, Todd Bergeron holding on to that lead over Maple Lake's Lenny Wurm. 1 minute and 40 seconds to go in the second period. Just underway in the second period from the Civic Center. And Mike, this hasn't been a good year for repeating champions.
No, sir, that's right. In fact, Todd's one of the few returners that's in the finals now.
I guess that just proves how tough it is to be able to come back and do it again. Doing it once is tough enough.
Very tough. Very tough. Every time these guys step on the mat, it's just a clean slate again. And just the man who wants it the worst and the guy who goes the hardest, he usually comes out on top. This match right now, 2-1, these two men both undefeated. And this is about how you'd expect a match to go. These guys both working very hard, somewhat cautious, yet wrestling a good, smart match, working hard, working for that position. They're in that tie-up position there. They're somehow looking for an opening.
Both wrestlers have been on the feet almost the whole match. We're halfway through. Now Bergeron trying to get around the back, can't do so as Wurm fights him off. They're off the mat. They'll move him to the middle.
Todd's working that head quite a bit. It looks like maybe he's looking for some type of a head throw. If he can score big here, it could be a real up for him, a real boost. Right now, again, the match still is anybody's match, although Lenny needs to get something going pretty quick here.
Now wrestlers off the mat. They'll move him to the middle with 32 seconds to go in the second period. Scoring early on in the first period, and we haven't seen anything since.
Nice little throw. He gets his 2 points, and he's got him on his back, but there they go.
Still has plenty of time in the second period, 15 seconds, as Wurm rolls out of that one.
2 point near fall.
6-1 now, Bergeron in the lead.
Nice hip toss. There's a possibility of 2 or 3 points, depending upon how long the man is held on his back, and that was a 2 point near fall there.
It's a 4 point move for Bergeron, moves him up 6-1.
That's gotta be a real confidence builder for him. Right now, Lenny needs to really fight back. He wants to get back into this match.
2 more minutes of wrestling as we enter this third period with Bergeron in the lead. And Wurm will start in the down position. Lenny Wurm, a junior out of Maple Lake, and Todd Bergeron, Oakley Plummer, his 105-pound championship at the state championships at the St. Paul Civic Center. 5-2. Wrestlers off the mat. It's going to be a big deficit for Lenny Wurm to get back into this one. 5 points.
Yeah, he's going to have to work here. They gave him a point on that last little flurry going off the mat. Looks like he got an escape point. Todd Bergeron in on that leg. Nice. I think right now Todd looks like he's doing a good job. He's controlling this mat. Very active. He's putting the pressure on Lenny.
1 minute and 15 seconds to go in this match.
Result,
wrestlers out of the circle. They're moving back to the middle.
AA 105 championship, Matt Bezik of New Prague, 7-2. Bezik, 7-2.
Really, Wurm's only chance right now is to somehow get Bergeron, take him down and snap him to his back to score some points as he has a minute to go.
Oh, nice little throw. That's the second time in this match now that Bergeron has done that little hip toss. 2 points, and he's getting back points.
Had him in the danger position.
He's in real good shape now.
For over 5 seconds, collects 3 points, 11-2. The lead now for Todd Bergeron. 40 seconds to go in the match. Mentioned that the AA match has just been completed. Matt Bezik, a winner over Fridley's Troy Melton, 7-2. Bezik from New Prague, the winner.
Another 1 point escape there. Lenny's got to be a little discouraged here, although he's still in there fighting. Nice attempt at a throw. Bergeron, good counter.
15 seconds to go in the match. An 8-point lead for Todd Bergeron. Six seconds to go. They'll move him to the middle once again, and Lenny Wurm will be back, no doubt, a junior. Todd Bergeron, the senior, could not be denied here in the 105-pound division as he defeats Lenny Wurm for the championship. The final score, 11-3. He's fired up.
Yeah, he's excited.
Result, match tie at 56.
Todd Bergeron defends his championship, and we'll be back with more wrestling from the St. Paul Civic Center in just a moment.
36-0. What were your thoughts going in? You certainly were keyed up for the match.
I wanted it bad, very bad. I know he's a tough kid, though.
Ladies and gentlemen,
really tough. One of your toughest matches of the season?
Oh, yeah, he's really good on his feet. Real good kid.
College and your plans next?
Oh, yeah. Start looking.
All right, Todd Bergeron, our champ at 105 pounds. Thank you, Todd. We're going to be back with more coverage from the Minnesota State High School Wrestling Tournament coming up in just 1 moment.
Dana Crona, 138. That's been one of the wrestlers, or Jones has been one of the wrestlers who has really turned this crowd on, defeating two returning state champions to get into the finals. And he's going to meet a tough match with Dana Crone.
He's got to be on a high, though, being a high going into that last final match after beating two state champs.
A crowd of 10,000 tonight would set a new attendance record for the Minnesota State High School League here in St. Paul. And
a lot of action.
Doing a quick count, I'd say it's going to be close. Now we pick up action in the AA match with Brian Westerlund and Tom Menny. Menny in the maroon, the Forest Lake Rangers.
Tom Menny off to a rip-roaring start here. There's a two-point takedown.
Tom Menny in the lead, 2-0. 50 seconds to go in the first period. This one's just underway.
Strategy here, the man who's riding on top, what he wants to do is he wants to break the man off his base. Somehow, if he can get him to his stomach and control those hips like Tom's doing here. Tom's got a leg in, and right now his opponent can't do really too much with that hip being controlled. Once the man, though, has the control, he wants to start looking for some type of a turn. Right there, Tom's working an arm, hopefully wanting to take that arm back and take his opponent to the back.
Time running down. You can see it in the upper corner of your screen. 14 seconds remaining in this first period. All eyes on the middle of that mat. It's a lonely place to be when you're on the bottom, that's for sure.
That's right.
Nice thing about wrestling, you can tell what's going on out there. No uniforms, no equipment to hide anything. It's all out there in the open.
Yeah, it's so different from a team sport. There's nobody else to depend on but yourself, and I guess there's advantages and disadvantages with that.
2-0 after one period. And here's an interesting point that the new rules in high school wrestling to make it a little more exciting. The wrestler has many more options. Now we see the wrestler starting on their feet. That's one of their options.
Right. There's four options now. The wrestler who has a choice can choose to go in the top position. He can choose to go in the bottom position. He can choose to go on the feet, or he can choose to wait and choose the last period and give the choice to the other wrestler.
And the old rule was you're up or you're down, one or the other.
That's right.
So it adds in a little more strategy. Certainly a wrestler who's good on his feet would like to stay up there as long as possible.
And that's what Tom Menny's doing here.
Now locked up there with Westerlund. You see the wrestlers walking each other around the ring. It doesn't look like they're really doing much of anything, but what are they trying to accomplish there, Mike?
Well, they're trying to look for some type of an opening where they can shoot in on a leg or where they can grab an ankle or work some type of a throw. You'll see a lot of times wrestlers will tie up an arm or an ankle and they'll do quick little movements just for that purpose, like right there. Nice attempt. He opened up his opponent. He worked the arm a little bit, snuck his head underneath, and did a duck under.
55 seconds to go in the second period. The match is half over, and Tom Menny with that flurry at the beginning of the match holds on to that 2-0 lead, but back comes Westerlund. Now they're off the mat.
These men are both primed. Real good reactions out there. Tom looks real confident. He looks like he's wrestling real well. Feels like he has control here. Actually, both men wrestling very well. Brian needs to get something going here.
Now the headgear of Menny falling off as wrestlers out of the circle. 31 seconds to go in the second period. It'll be interesting to watch, Mike, as we progress through the evening. The different weight classes and strategies in each. These smaller, lower weight wrestlers, quicker on their feet.
Right. The upper weights, we tend to see a little more power, little slower movements. When the upper weights do something, nice fireman's carry. Not quite there yet. Nice flurry of wrestling we're seeing right now.
No points awarded yet, so Menny still holding on to that lead. Trying to turn him over as the second period's coming to a close. 5 seconds to go. And it appears as if Menny won't be able to get anything out of it.
Result.
So it's 2-0 after two periods. Brian Westerlund down to Tom Menny. Menny of Forest Lake, Westerlund from New Prague High School.
Brian wants to go on the feet again.
Certainly gained some confidence from the closing moments of that second period, and Menny had his move on, but Westerlund was able to fight out of it.
Must have felt he maybe saw a weakness, an area where he can attack now. Both men again locked up. Referee's not going to let that lock go too long without giving some type of a stalling warning. When both men are in a position and they're locked up and nobody seems to be working for action, there's a possibility. Nice takedown there by Westerlund, by Menny.
That moves his lead out to 4 points, 4-0, with 1 minute and 10 seconds to go in this match.
Tom Menny does a good job of riding with that leg. Brian Westerlund, probably very frustrated right now, not able to do anything from that bottom position. There's still time.
Just looking at Menny, he wants the ball. You can see it on his face.
He sure does.
Leading 4-0 with a minute and two to go. Menny holding on.
Merritt, 4-1.
Mike,
can you tell what Manny's trying to work on there?
Well, it looks like he's going for some type of a tilt with the leg there. Now he's working back to that arm. What he wants to do is he...
Oh, Westman, a nice job rolling out of that one.
Super job, super job.
Two points for the reversal, 4-2.
Puts him right back in the match.
He can get a near fall, he can win the match. He'll need a 3-point near fall to do it.
Very possible right now, very possible that Brian Westerlund can come back. He's looking for a quick tilt there. If he can tilt the shoulders and hold him there for more than 2 seconds, he'll score points.
15 seconds to go. Time running out on Westerlund, down 4-2.
He's not quitting, he's going for it though.
4-1.
Referee calls a stalemate.
4-1.
8 seconds to go in the match, so Westerlund needs to snap him down and
they're
starting a down position.
I think we'll see Brian Westerlund here really take a chance and really go for a quick turn.
Please go to the press table area.
Westerlund.
Tom Minnie, the new state champion at 112 pounds in class AA. He's fired up.
He sure is, you bet. He is.
Four to two, the final score between Tom Menny and Brian Westerlund. And we'll be back with more wrestling in just a moment.
Tom, leg rides and good takedowns, a little bit of freestyle experience seemed to be helping you in that match tonight.
Yeah, I knew he was a good wrestler and I had to keep him down with the legs. And on top of all that, I knew he was good from the feet and I didn't know how I was going to take him down. So I had to change the way I was wrestling early in the tournament because I knew he'd be watching me. So I wasn't shooting on this side of the leg. I shot to the other side, and it paid off.
He certainly didn't give you anything easy, did he?
No, he didn't. He's a tough wrestler. I'll give him a lot of credit.
What now after high school?
Well, I'm going on to school, Division I, but I'm really undecided.
Tom Menny, our state champ, class AA from Forest Lake. Congratulations on winning.
Thank you very much. It's great.
Tom Menny. We'll be back with more from the state.
Robert again, and last year I got the semis, and this year to go all the way is just great.
A little bit further every year.
Yeah, it's been great.
Was winning the state how it would feel as you thought it would feel?
Oh, I think so. Probably even a little bit better with my dad's support and both my coaches. It just makes it, it's all I've ever wanted. Thanks.
Corey, congratulations on a state championship in Class A. Clarissa is proud, I'm sure of that.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Corey Bennett, state champion from Clarissa here in the Class A state tournament. We'll be back. 119 pounds is coming up next. Please stay tuned. Watch for this.
Mr. Mayo, a senior, 28-0 on the season. Anger had an 8-4 semifinal victory over Jeff Board of Coon Rapids. Todd will be taking on John Hakala of Virginia, a senior, 33-1-1. Hakala had an exciting 5-4 last-minute victory over Jeff Hobbish of Buffalo in the semifinals.
And we're back ready for wrestling in the 119-pound division. North versus South, actually, here with Rochester Mayo's Todd Hanger versus Virginia's John Hakala. Both seniors. This will be their final match in high school. Hakala in the blue singlet. The Rochester wrestler Todd Hanger in the green. It's got to be a good match.
That's right. Right away, he comes out right away, scores 2 points. Real confident, real strong.
As Jim Bartels mentioned, Anger defeating Jeff Board from Coon Rapids and Hakala defeating Jeff Habish. Enter into tonight's meet. Anger at 28-0-0. Hakala at 33-1-1. Anger's trying to set him up for some type of throw.
Yeah, we see more upper body wrestling now in the high school level. I think we see more in the college also. I think it's the influence from the international styles of wrestling. And, good upper body wrestling, open the man up, try to get in on the leg. Sometimes a throw comes up.
2-1 with the Virginia wrestler in the lead.
Nice attempt.
Anger quickly scooting around. Getting the 2 points for the takedown. 3-2 now, Todd Anger in the lead. Wrestler's off the mat. 36 seconds to go in the first period.
can already see the wrestlers starting to pant a little bit after a minute and a half. Mike, that's hard work out there.
Well, these guys both came out just working real hard, and they're not pacing themselves. They know this is the last match of the season. The state title's on the line. They're both seniors, and both these guys are going for it. Probably work harder in this match than they have in any other match of their life. Todd Enger now again working with that leg, riding the leg ride. Referee signals a stalemate. Give him a fresh start. See the two officials on the mat. They have what's called a lead official and a trail official. Lead official has the final word and makes all the calls. The trail official is there to assist. The lead official can call on him anytime he wants a little help with the call.
It's really important at this level of competition.
Right, they don't want to make any mistakes. These guys have put a lot of work into this, and they don't want to make sure everything's right on the mat and all the calls are correct. These referees, by the way, do a super job.
You can say that now because you're off the mat.
That's right.
Todd Enger in the lead, 3-2.
Nice action. Reversal there by Todd Enger.
Two more points for him. He leads 5-2 now over John Akala from Virginia.
Better be careful there. He's on his back.
That could be a potentially dangerous move as Akala gets out of it.
Good action. Seeing some good action again. Referee signals stalemate position or potentially dangerous. They take a lot of precautions here. A lot of rules that have to do with danger positions. And the referees, another reason I think for the two referees is so they can make sure that neither of these young men get injured.
Akala, a three-time region champ. Been third and fifth in the state tournament, so he's been had plenty of mat time here at the St. Paul Civic Center. Actually, Virginia has a couple of wrestlers here in the finals tonight. It's a tribute to their program. Enger, the lone Rochester wrestler.
Enger doing a good job now, riding those legs, keeping those legs tied up, controlling. Looks like he's a little high there. He could be in trouble. We'll see how John comes out of it. Again, referee whistles him off the mat. Give him a fresh start again.
43 seconds to go, second period. Just past the halfway mark. 3 2-minute periods in high school wrestling. Yet to see a fall yet, Mike. Kind of surprises me. Take a look at the coaches for tonight. Dale Owens, the head coach for the Rochester Mayo team, Roger Nelson for Virginia.
Back to not seeing a fall. You know, you get to the finals of a tournament, and a lot of times these guys are so evenly matched that you have close matches. Usually you see the falls, one wrestler is so much better than his opponent that he can get the fall. But in the finals, a lot of times of a tournament like this, you don't see a lot of falls.
Anger doing a nice job. Hackle is working awfully hard. The bottom position to get out of there. His time is running down in this second period.
John's just real steady there, constantly keeping the pressure on, doing a good job. John, take a love fights back.
Didn't get any points out of it, so it'll be up to the Virginia wrestler to put things together in this final 2 minutes. Those wrestlers will start on their feet. It was Hackler's decision. Or perhaps his coach's decision, Roger Nelson. So apparently, Hackler has picked out a weakness and is ready to go for it here with the takedown.
Nice, quick little snap down, goes behind, referee signals two.
Oh, he's going for it. He gives up the 1 point for the escape.
Didn't work that time. Todd Enger comes back with a quick takedown. Real competitive match here.
Now it's a 4-point lead for Anger.
112 participants should be at the test table now. All
still plenty of time for Hakala. 20 seconds to go in the match.
Todd Anger again back to that leg ride.
What's he working for there, Mike?
Well, right now he's working for a breakdown.
He's working for a turn. Class A.
Controlling that arm real well.
Match 560, overtime. Ted Jewis from Janesville. Mike Morgan, Natalie.
45
Underwood.
Seconds to go on the match now.
Todd right now with his lead is, I think, looking to be somewhat cautious and just trying to control his opponent right now.
Result,
and not give him, let him have any position where he's able to score from.
Jeff Hottage of Buffalo, 8-1.
Now with 41 seconds to go, John Hakala needs to get up and out of there, or a reversal or something, to score some points.
He does. He definitely needs points here. But Todd's doing a good job. He's controlling him real well. He's taking him off his base. Not giving John too much of an opportunity to do anything.
Tackle it to his base.
Result.
Anger's just all over him, though.
He is. He's doing a good job. Quick little escape.
Still some time. 10 seconds.
Petrich, 9-6.
And Todd Anger from Rochester Mayo will finish off here with an undefeated season,
and he's happy.
Undefeated champion at 119 pounds, Todd Anger.
Double A match.
The final score, 8-5, and Rochester has a new winner. Back with more wrestling after this. In overtime, it appears that Mike Morgan from Battle Lake Underwood.
Class A, match 160 on mat one.
Ted Jewison are going at it from Janesville. And the Janesville wrestler, the winner in the 119-pound division. In overtime, wow, what a match. Back with more wrestling in just a moment.
The footage we've got here from your match when you're going with your opponent there from Janesville. Can you remember recalling some of that, what was going on there?
Yeah, I couldn't keep him down. He kept high-legging over. And I was just trying to keep him down on the mat, and I couldn't do it. He was good.
Mike, you had a state championship 2 years ago. This one just as sweet?
Yeah, it is. Feels good. In my last year here, I wanted to do something. With it.
Good job, Mike Morgan, state champion from Battle Lake. Congratulations again.
Thanks.
Mike Morgan, Battle Lake Underwood. We're going to have more wrestling coming up. 126 on Dane Barrett of Columbia Heights, a senior who's 19-0 on the season. Barrett had a 12-0 semifinal victory over Rob Strand of Bemidji.
Columbia Heights.
Jim Skelly and Mike Hawk ready for action in this state wrestling tournament at 126 pounds. Ed Kelm of Shakopee and Dane Barrett. Dane Barrett, third place in the state at the 119-pound division last year. Comes in with an unbeaten record, 19-0. Kelm at 19-5, a junior out of Shakopee.
Dane Barrett in on a double leg. Nice. There's points. Quick reversal.
Looks like we're going to have a heck of a match here in the first half a minute. A
lot of action here.
Both wrestlers scoring points, tied up at 2 points apiece.
It's like there were some back points awarded there to Ed Kelm.
Let's go through quickly the awarding of back points, Mike.
Well, for back points, you have to hold your opponent on his back for at least 2 seconds. And if you hold him there for more than 5 seconds, you get 3 points. If you hold him there for more than two, it's worth 2 points.
And it's a 45-degree angle plane that they have to cross in order to collect the points.
And they have to have control also. If a wrestler's on his back and his opponent doesn't have the control, the referee's not going to start to count. A lot of action here.
Barrett trying to throw in the switch. Kelm holding on. 126-pound division. Getting up there on size.
One point escape. Dane Barrett.
Maybe one of those high-scoring matches, Mike.
It looks like it could be.
Just a minute into this one. Barrett, the Region 5 AA champion out of Columbia Heights. Been around the state meet a couple of years, has plenty of mat time here at the St. Paul Civic Center. Kelm with a 43-22 overall record, so he's really put it together this year, the junior from Shakopee. The Region 2 champion.
Nice, quick little snap down. 2 points, Dane Barrett.
Five to four the score. Coming down into the final seconds of this first period as the wrestlers approach the corner of the mat. Stalemate called. And lead official Pete Feldman will move him to the middle.
Well, the lead's changed three times now.
That old saying, it's anyone's match, sure comes in here.
That's right.
That's right. That's it for the first period. The coin flip comes out. It's pretty even at this point, with Dane Barrett holding on to a 5-4 lead over Ed Kelm.
Looks like Ed Kelm won the toss there, and he deferred the choice to Dane Barrett. Dane shows down.
In the Class A division at 126, Chris Pressler from Bruton and Joe Block from La Center are going at it. Joe Block holding on to a 7-1 lead, but there's an injury timeout on that match as we wait for action to start in Class AA. They're set and ready to wrestle. Barrett can't get out of there.
Quick little explosion right off the whistle. He's looking for a switch. Goes behind, 2 points.
Looks like Barrett likes that switch. That's the second time he's throwing it in there.
He does. He must feel real strong from that bottom position, too. He chose down that time.
Now Kelm getting to his feet. He was able to escape for a one-point score. Last time this happened. Barrett having a little trouble getting him back down from the standing position.
Right now, if he doesn't return him to the mat, well, there's an escape. There's a danger there of being called for passivity. The wrestler must return his opponent to the mat in that type of a position or situation. Ed Kelm there, looking for a good shot. And on a single, back to a neutral position again.
Thus far, Mike, we've seen all the matches go the full allotment of time, 6 minutes.
Yeah, that's quite common when you get to the finals of a state tournament like this. Really, it's anybody's match until the very end. Nice. Nice attempt there.
Still Barrett holding on to that 7-5 lead.
Dean Barrett is looks like a very explosive wrestler.
Seconds to go in the second period. Barrett, I don't think it's going to end up in a 7-5 score.
I don't think so either. I think we're going to see more action. Oh, nice. Takes him right to his back. 2-point takedown. He's getting back points.
Gets the 3-point near fall.
That's not a comfortable position to be in there for Ed Kelm. Is 3 points, referee signaling that.
10 seconds to go in this second period. Kelm gets out of the danger position. And that's the end of the second period. 12-5 the score, Dane Barrett on top.
A lot of action in this match so far.
Barrett, who finished third place at 119 pounds. Experience at the state tournament level helps.
Oh, definitely, definitely. Just being here, knowing what it feels like, being under the pressure of a state tournament, knowing what the crowd's
crowd's like. It's, boy, it just could make the difference between winning and losing the state title. And Dane Barrett's wrestling very well tonight, showing confidence of one who's been here before. Action in the third period, 1 minute and 35 seconds. You're on the match, shall they stop it in a stalemate? Quick little breakdown. Dane Barrett takes him off his base. Now he's looking for a tilt. Referee signals no points. Pulls him back. Dane Barrett really working here, doing a super job, keeping the pressure on, looking for those back points. He's not satisfied with that 12-5 lead. He wants to keep racking up that score and keep wrestling hard. He's doing a super job. Good reaction. No points. No score in this third period, a minute to go. Barrett took a 12-5 lead into this final period and holding on to it. Now they'll move the wrestlers back. Referee signaled a stalling warning there. I'm not sure who it's on though. Warning the talking to the Shakopee wrestler, Ed Kelm. Just assume it's on him. Yeah, that would be my guess. Dane Barrett's working very hard here. I think Ed Kelm's probably a little bit discouraged here. He's down last period, 43 seconds. It's 12-5. Dane Barrett doing a super job, though. Keeps the pressure on. He just keeps coming, keeps coming. It'd be a good feeling for Barrett. All he needs to do is hold on for another 36 seconds, and he's the new state champion.
Yeah,
Ed Kelm needs to come back here. If he wants to do anything, he's really got to just explode and get out of there. He's wrestling a good wrestler here in Dane Barrett, though. Nice attempt there by Ed Kelm. So he could get a point. Nope, Dane Barrett keeps the pressure on.
Well, Barrett has won nearly 90 matches in his high school career against 8 losses, and he's 18 seconds away from a state championship.
This will be something
that's eluded him.
This will be his highlight. Nice way to end his senior year.
Red Kelm, he'll have another year. He's a junior at Shakopee.
He'll be back with the experience that Dane Barrett has this year, and I think we can look for some good things from Ed next year.
As Kelm gets out of that, he'll get a point for the escape. And that's the match. Dane Barrett the winner, the final score. Dane Barrett 14, Ed Kelm 5. Great action at 126. We'll be back with more wrestling in just a moment.
And then there's Nonnie Colmar, a lively girl, just being silly as lively girls are. She suddenly finds someone's fingers around her throat and ends up as a piece of meat.
Masterpiece Theater brings you J.B. Priestley's Lost Empires.
Magic. That's a strong word. What would you call it? Deception.
Lost Empires on Masterpiece Theater.
Jim Skelly and Mike Howe back at the 1987 Minnesota State High School Wrestling Tournament. We're at the 126-pound division. We're expecting a lot of more great wrestling here tonight, Mike.
Yeah, we have a lot of wrestling ahead of us and some good matchups, it looks like.
And Steve Icano and Joe Seeger coming up next at 132 in Class AA. We'll look forward to that.
That should be a
great... We'll be back with an interview with Dane Barrett in just a moment.
Hi, I'm Brian Wadlevich, an attorney from Appleton, Minnesota, and your host on Pioneer Public TV's Legal Lines. Next on Legal Lines, we're bringing you a show on landlord-tenant law. Landlords find it very frustrating sometimes to get rid of a bad tenant with the delays that it takes in the present court system. On the other hand, tenants sometimes still suffer an illegal lockout by landlords. Join us to discuss this and other issues Tuesday night on Legal Lines. My guest attorneys will be Ron Frauenschuh from Mortonville and David McLaughlin from Mortonville. That's Tuesday night on Legal Lines. See you then.
26 pounds in Class AA. Dane is with us right now. Dane, obviously you got in an open style of match. It was wide open. It was exciting. That's what you like to perform in, isn't it?
Yeah. A lot of freestyle going wide open. I got caught in the beginning of the period, but came off my back to win it, and I don't know. I just felt pretty confident all the way through. It's a little tired, but at the end it came through and I won it.
Isn't it true, though, in a match like that, when you're going wide open, you occasionally know that you'll probably give up a point or two to get a couple extra?
Oh, yeah, but that just goes along with going wide open and scoring all the points, you know, just run it up, trying to get over 15 and try to do it, you know.
How long have you been wrestling? I know that I've seen you around in youth wrestling for many years.
Well, I've been wrestling since about age 5, started in kindergarten all the way through freestyle all the way up through now, so it's been about 12 years, I'd say 13 years wrestling.
Dane Barrett, our state champion at 126 pounds out of Columbia Heights. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
We're going to go back now to Jim and Mike.
We have live wrestling in the 126-pound A division. Joe Block from La Center and Chris Pressler from Bruton.
Nice.
And it's Block in the lead here.
Super throw.
Block's lead to 11-8. He may get some back points here with 10 seconds to go.
He's got him in a good position for a fall, too.
See if he has time. Well, that pretty much sews up the match for him, I'd say.
Time running down, and it's over.
Nice job.
A big cheer from the crowd for Joe Block from La Center, a winner. Over Chris Pressler from Broughton, the only loss for Pressler this year, 11-8, the final score. Back with more wrestling after this.
And then there's Nonnie Colmar, a lively girl, just being silly as lively girls are. She suddenly finds someone's fingers around her throat and ends up as a piece of meat.
Masterpiece Theater brings you J.B. Priestley's Lost Empires.
Magic. That's a strong word. What would you call it? Deception.
Lost Empires on Masterpiece Theater.
An impressive flurry at the end for La Center's Joe Block, the new 1987 Class A champion at 126 pounds. Let's go over to Jim Bartels.
Joe Block, La Center, our state champion, 14-8. Boy, you had the crowd all excited. A lot of throws. You yourself got on your back once, but a lot of throws that you had to your opponent from Bruton on his back, too.
Yeah, that's the crowd was a heavy-duty factor. I was hoping we'd bring up some spectator buses, and we did. And throws, I figured he'd beat me on my feet, singles and doubles, and wrestle freestyle all summer and stuff, and I thought, throw him, and I got it. Heavy-duty.
Looking there at the screen, we see some throws going on. There you've got your opponent on his back. Did you think you were going to put him away there?
Yeah, I did. For a second, he was that far from being stuck, and I was praying the whole time. Oh, man, it's a dream.
Joe, you're a sophomore. Congratulations. Good luck next year.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
Joe Block, our state champion from La Center. We'll be back with more wrestling coming up from the Civic Center in St. Paul with 132-pound action. Stay tuned after this.
Comes to weaning.
The local broadcast of the Minnesota State High School Wrestling Tournament on Pioneer Public TV is made possible in part by the following businesses. The Farmers and Merchants State Bank and the F&M Insurance Agency of Clarkfield, who want to congratulate the area wrestlers for their fine achievements. By Freetley Electric Incorporated of Appleton and Kirkhoven, featuring dual heat, air conditioning, and residential demand control. And by the Farmers Cooperative Elevator of Dawson, Dirdall Lumber and Construction Company of Hazel Run, the Farmers and Merchants State Bank of Painesville, the Consumers Co-op Oil Company of Clarkfield, Rooflat Plumbing and Heating of Clarkfield, J&J Marine of Appleton, the State Bank of Murdoch and the First Murdoch Agency, Appleton Oil of Appleton, G&T Food of Painesville, Myers on Main of Appleton, Dooley's Petroleum Incorporated of Murdoch, and Lohr's Sports Center of Appleton.
Cano and Joe Seeger from Grand Rapids. Should be a good one. We'll have it for you in just a moment.
Virginia.
These co-op tires are covered by a 60-month field hazard warranty.
We promised you we'd be back with a second show on medical imaging, and that's going to be happening this week on Call for Health. Please join Dr. Albert Rui, Dr. Richard Hazen, Dr. Smith, and myself when we take you through the world of Dopplers, CT scans, and digital subtraction angiograms. Sounds complicated, but they're really quite simple and are very useful in diagnosing some of the problems that you may have. So join us Tuesday at 8 p.m. right here on Call for Help.
This is member-supported Pioneer Public TV.
.32 Class AA. Finalists are Steve Iacono of Osseo, a senior, 31-0-1. Iacono had a 7-2 victory in the semifinals over Pat Larson of Forest Lake. He'll be wrestling Joe Seeger of Grand Rapids, a senior, 25-1-1. Seeger had a last-second win over Corey Leopold of Mound West Tonka, 4-2 in the semifinals. Seeger also happens to be a rare individual in that he was a six-time Region 7 champion.
And we have live action here at the St. Paul Civic Center, and this, I called it the dream match at the beginning. It's a wrestler from Grand Rapids, Joe Seeger, set some kind of world record with six region championships, I think, Mike.
Outstanding.
And Steve Iacono from Osseo, the only match he lost last year was in the state championship. He hasn't lost one this year.
This should be a good match, and both men here coming out real strong. Little cautious, maybe, but that's all right.
No points awarded. We're a half a minute into this 132-pound championship. Iacono's been the top-rated wrestler much of the season.
Steve Iacono behind there. No points yet. Steve Iacono looks like a strong upper body wrestler. There's a two-point takedown.
The Osseo wrestler trying to walk the ladder, so to speak. As a sophomore, he finished third in the state. Last year, he finished second in the state to John Beatty from Rosemount. This year, the natural progression would put him in the state championship, but it just isn't that easy.
That's right. It doesn't always work that way.
Iacono in the Osseo singlet, the black with the orange stripes. Seeger also in black with the big Rapids in front for Grand Rapids.
Joe looking for a quick little roll there. Iacono did a nice adjustment and countered. One-point escape. Joe Seeger.
Might be a good time to mention while we have a Grand Rapids wrestler on the mat.
Headlock attempt there. No points yet, but he's got it tight. Steve comes out of it. He goes back again to that headlock. These guys both look like they like that upper body wrestling.
An impressive first period.
Both wrestlers very strong. Both came out very strong. Again, here we're seeing a little difference in styles. We saw that quickness of those lighter weight wrestlers. Now as we progress up a little bit to the heavier weights, we're seeing more strength and more power involved. And these guys tonight, both very strong wrestlers, both like that upper body. In the second period here now.
Iacono holding on to the lead. And one thing I want to mention before we get to the action here, Mike, is that Simley is a Class AA champion, and they defeated Grand Rapids, the team that Seeger wrestles for in the championship, 30-17. So Simley, the winner. We'll see some Simley wrestlers later on here tonight. This is our first look at a Grand Rapids wrestler.
Iacono still in control, returns his opponent back to the mat again. It's so important when a wrestler is on bottom, if he gets taken off his base and broken down to the mat, it's so important for him to fight back up to his good solid base and then go to work from there. It's hard to do anything when you're on your stomach, and Joe Seeger here is doing a good job of coming up off his base. There he comes up to his feet, looking for a stand-up, back reverses to a switch, and the referee says 1 point escape, both on their feet again. And that ties up the match, 2-2.
About halfway done with this match in the 126-pound division, or 132, rather. Steve Iacono from Osseo High School. Joe Seeger from Grand Rapids.
Steve Iacono working that underhook and trying to straighten him up again, looking for that upper body kind of technique. A lot of times a wrestler will work that upper body as a setup and then shoot in on a leg. That's been very effective.
Iacono, a member of the prestigious 100 Victory Club. His headgear falls off there. Three-time late conference, all-conference wrestler.
Close-up shot there, Steve Iacono.
How important is the headgear?
Very important. Protects the ears. Common injury in wrestling is cauliflower ears, and they call it cauliflower ear because your ear looks like a cauliflower that gets damaged, and headgear serves to protect that.
Well, Iacono having a little trouble with it as Seeger tries to flip him over. They're off the mat. 15 seconds to go in the second period. Little thing like that get on you out there and your headgear doesn't stay on? Do you start thinking about that instead of the wrestling?
Well, not really. I don't think. That's probably why it's coming off. He's probably not thinking about his headgear.
There's a look at Dan Jinx. He's out there on the mat too, it seems.
Yeah.
Sometimes coaches are funner to watch than the wrestling, but not in this match. We've got some good action here. It's a tie. This time is running down in this second period, 2-2. These two have wrestled before they tied at the team level. Right now it's a tie. Maybe we'll see overtime here, who knows. How difficult is it? Now, both these wrestlers wrestled team earlier here. Are they rested, or is this a...
I'm sure they're both tired. They're in good shape, but to come here and to wrestle in the team tournament, to wrestle in the individual tournament, it's very, very tough. Yet part of the sport of wrestling, the men are sure in good shape, and mentally they put that out of their minds, and they're just out here going for the state title.
Iacono without a loss this year. Seeger with only one loss.
Seeger riding that leg good now. Looking to turn him with that arm. Referee stops the action. Potentially dangerous situation. Looking to protect the wrestler's arm there. Good call by the referee.
Iacono out for 1 point. It was interesting that time. Joe Seeger started with a different type of a start. It's something that's also new is the international type start. And gave Steve Iacono the ability to get out for 1 point. Steve Iacono takes the lead, 3-2. Take a look at these two wrestlers. Now there's a timeout in the match. It looks like Seeger's got the bigger upper body.
Yeah,
a little shorter, stockier wrestler.
Yeah, you see the difference here in body types. You know, that's one of the nice things about wrestling is it's suited for all body types, all different weights, and we have two totally different styles here on the mat.
132, won by Roy Wurm of Maple Lake, 3-2.
One minute to go in this match. Iacono holding on to a 3-2 lead. The slightest mistake now would lose it for either wrestler.
That's right. Joe Seeger is coming on real tough. He is just going after Steve Iacono. He knows he needs to score here with a minute to go. Really, there's no reason to hold back. And he wants this bad. Both these men want this title bad. Nice shot. Good action. They're picking it up here in the last minute.
We need a faster report time by all of you winners, all of you participants.
Much of the wrestling done on the feet. Seeger looking to score a takedown.
Now
we're off the mat. 44 seconds to go.
Steve Iacono wrestling cautious now and just looking to stay out of any dangerous situation.
The referee warns him for stalling. Good call by the referee. He gets one warning. The next time, Seeger would get a point.
Yeah, that's right.
Nice flurry, good action. Oh, referee signals 2 points. Seeger gets him. He's in the lead 4-3 with 22 seconds to go. Both wrestlers will get a chance to catch their breath and then look out. Icano needs to get out of there. Seeger needs to hold on.
Steve Icano coming right up to his feet.
He needs a 1 point would give him an escape for a tie. 15 seconds.
Right now he's trying to control those wrists, break that lock that Joe Seeger has on him. If he can do that and he get away for one.
Seeger looks at the clock. It says 7.
Seeger doing a good job there. Another shot of the Grand Rapids coach. Yelling some instructions there to his wrestler.
No doubt he's just saying, hold on, 7 seconds.
That's right.
In the match. Icano desperately trying to get that 1 point escape, but he is not going to get it.
It's all over.
Perhaps we have an upset here at 132. Joe Seeger from Grand Rapids, 6 region championships. He gets a state championship over Steve Icano from Osseo.
And then there's Nonnie Colmar, a lively girl, just being silly as lively girls are. She suddenly finds someone's fingers around her throat and ends up as a piece of meat.
Masterpiece Theater brings you J.B. Priestley's Lost Empires.
Magic. That's a strong word. What would you call it? Deception.
Lost Empires on Masterpiece Theater.
Jim Skelly and Mike Houck back with more wrestling from the St. Paul Civic Center. Boy, what an exciting match we had in Class AA, as well as Patrick Lorenzen defeated Jim Biskins. Lorenzen, actually, let's get the right pronunciation for this state champion. Lorenzen from Greenbush, 6-5 over Jim Biskins from Belle Plaine. We'll have an interview with the new AA champion when we come back with more of the state wrestling tournament.
The local broadcast of the Minnesota State High School.
For that second caution, there's a point. But with the tied up and win overtime, I wouldn't mind that at all.
Joe Seeger, congratulations as state champion. An exciting man.
It was great. Been down here 6 years and I haven't done it.
Joe Seeger, state champion. We'll be back after this. Patrick, you had to come from behind on that one. Quite a comeback.
Yeah, I don't know. I figured the last 6 minutes of my high school career and figured I'd give 110%. It's sort of the dream since second grade. The state champ.
Did you ever have any mental breakdown that you thought you might not come back?
No, I didn't have any. I just figured if I kept pushing him 6, he'd sooner or later wear out and I'd score on him.
So. Okay, congratulations again on winning that state title match.
Thank you.
We'll be back coming up. We've got 138-pound action coming up shortly. Stay tuned. We'll be back after this.
And we're live at 138. Dana Crone and Derek Jones. Both undefeated this year, and Derek Jones has been tearing through the field here at the state tournament.
He's having a great tournament tonight.
Defeating 2 former state champions, and Osseo's Darren Drogemuller, Matt Demaray from Apple Valley High School, foiled his chances at a 4-time state championship. Twenty seconds to go in this first period. No score.
Been out to somewhat of a slow start here. Again, that's all right. A lot of times you'll find the wrestlers would come out and be a little cautious at the beginning, kind of feel their opponent, see what he's like, see what he's all about. And then as the match progresses, they pick up the pace.
End of that first period, no score. Just another comment, Mike, about that 132-pound match in A, Patrick Lorenzen and Jim Biskins. Both of those wrestlers, Biskins, he's the top rank academically in his class, and Lorenzen is in the top 10 as well, so it was not only a physical meeting of two very finely conditioned athletes, but a meeting of the minds out there.
Nice. Jones in on a single leg. Takes him to the mat. 2-point takedown. Nice job.
2-1 the score.
Jim Short, the Simley coach, watches on. Watch his son Chris Short compete later on in the match in the 185-pound division. Short, the returning state champion at 185.
Looked like Derek Jones let him go there. He wanted to go back on the feet again, and I can see why. It looks like he's starting to warm up a little bit here. Derek Jones is getting on that single leg again, putting the pressure on.
What's Jones working for now? It looks like Krohn is in the defensive.
Yeah, Krohn is. Jones has that leg. He's not in the best position. He needs to penetrate a little bit more into the body. He needs to pull the leg in. The referee signals a stalemate.
Now Dana Krohn lying on his back, slow to get up. Halfway through this match. Now if he's winded or what, it appears that he's injured. Krohn out for a short injury timeout, and we'll return with more of this 138-pound match in just a moment. 38-pound division, Dana Krohn back and on the mat with 54 seconds to go in the second period of this match between Dana Krohn of Minneapolis Roosevelt and Derek Jones from Simley High School. Jones, a member of the state championship squad from Simley. As a matter of fact, that's the first state championship for the school in any sport.
Well, that's exciting. Looks like Derek Jones has an opportunity to come away with two state championship medals here.
Dana Krohn, certainly a worthy opponent. They're tied 2-2. 20 seconds to go in this second period. Krohn helping Minneapolis Roosevelt rise in its status in Minnesota wrestling. They gave the Osseo Orioles a good run for their money for the Region 5AA championship this year.
That Roosevelt team is really coming on.
As Jones shoots in there for a single, couldn't get it. 2-2 after two periods. What a close match here with 2 minutes of wrestling to go.
Very close. It looks like at this point in the match, too, neither wrestler is really willing to take a chance. They're still being a little bit cautious, and I think we may see some more action as the match progresses here.
Now here's a situation, Mike, where we have a wrestler in Derek Jones who wrestled team this afternoon. Dana Krohn, on the other hand, did not wrestle team. Is that an advantage?
Yeah, it can be. Although in some ways for Derek Jones it can be very beneficial because he's warmed up and get after a three-day tournament. I guess if I had my choice, I'd rather be in Dana Krohn's position, be a little more fresh and a little well rested.
4-2. Foot 4-2.
Dana Krohn here, riding and working for a breakdown, controlling that wrist.
But Derek Jones very reluctant to turn over to his back. Now he escapes. 1 point for Jones. He leads 3-2. 1 minute and 5 seconds to go in the match.
Considering the pace of this match, that puts Jones in a pretty good position right now. And he's attacking again. Nice!
Whoa! Oh! Krohn landed right on his head. If Jones wouldn't have pulled back a little bit, it might have been an injury.
That's right, and it could have been a slam, but Jones did a super job of bringing him safely to the mat and scored a two-point takedown. Then we have an escape by Krohn. Scores 5-3. Derek Jones now looks like he's in good position with 35 seconds to go in this match.
No doubt Krohn will be working for a takedown. Time slowly running out on him.
Yeah, Krohn's definitely in this still. I mean, it's not over yet. So, fighting back hard here. Controlling that arm, looking for a setup.
I think Jones can sense it now.
He got a point for stalling against Jones.
Now a takedown would do it for Dana Krohn. 5-4 the score.
Result, Class A.
Nice attempt at a single there by Krohn. Jones in on a double, a single leg.
4-2. Anderson, 4-2.
And that's the match. So Derek Jones comes into this one with a state championship after upsetting two previous state championships. He defeats Dana Krohn at 138 pounds.
I'm Marty Stout.
Person who many are, people are calling the wrestler of the tournament. What a tournament he's had. Knocked off two state champions. Matt Demery, first of all, from Apple Valley. Then Darren Druggemuller from Osseo. You're on the team that won the state. Derek, in the watch here on the screen. We're going to have some footage coming up. Some excitement in your match. Here it is. Let's watch it and tell us what's happening.
I got in a deep single leg, and he was counting pretty good. He was heavy. And I got in there, and I just picked it up because I knew I could get him on that. I picked him up. He'd been getting away from it earlier, but I knew I had a better grip. He was strong.
Derek, you had worked out with him in the past. He was an old workout partner of yours, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was pretty tough then, but I'm better now. I should have won by more. I don't mean to be arrogant or nothing, but
Derek Jones, our state champion. Congratulations again on the 138-pound title.
Thank you.
Derek Jones, we'll be back with more right after this. Mark Anderson of Maple Lake with a state title. 4-2 final victory here, ending up this season at 138 pounds. Got into a takedown game at the end there, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
What, he let you go, wanted to take a gamble, and you came back with a takedown?
Yeah. Well, he was going upper body, and I just threw headlock, and I came up with the points, I guess.
Mark, you had an older brother who was a state champion. A little bit of inner rivalry in the house at home?
Well, no. I was hurt during the season. It was my last year, and he pushed me. You know, we don't rivalry at all. He's just so supportive.
You work out together at all?
Yeah. I broke my hand during the season, and during Christmas vacation,
We've got to go. Time's running short. Mark Anderson, state champ. We'll be back with more after this.
Over Dane Head of Casson-Manterville.
And we're back, ready for live wrestling. Let's go right down to the mat. Corey Olson and Chad Bodine. As we move up into the weights, we're now in the 145-pound classification. In Class AA, it's Tim Tuzingnot from Faribault against David Grousam from Mankato West.
Nice attempt there by Corey. Oh, good counter. Super counter by Chad Bodine. Got Corey on his back. He's getting points. Oh, he's in trouble.
We have yet to see a pin in a championship match, but this one's close with 1 minute to go in this first period.
And he's got a fall.
The Hayfield wrestler wins it.
Nice counter off that double leg takedown. Took him right to his back.
We'll have more wrestling from the St. Paul Civic Center right after this. Seven Minnesota State High School Individual Wrestling Championships. Battle of some outstate wrestlers. Dave Grousam from Mankato West leading. Tim Tuzingnot from Faribault. The red of Mankato West, Grousam. This is the final match for Laverne Flower, the longtime coach for the Mankato West team, 36 years at the helm of Mankato West. I'm sure it wasn't Mankato West that entire time. No. City's grown some since he started.
That's right.
And it's Grousam out to the lead, the Mankato wrestler. Two-time region champ from Mankato. An escape for the Faribault wrestler.
3 o'clock tomorrow at the high school.
And he's in the lead.
3 Mile High School.
Tuzingnot in the lead.
Good action there. Snapped out.
Creates a little bit more excitement with the A match complete now. All eyes are focused on this double A championship match.
Nice, quick little arm drag attempt.
Once again, Mike, as we get up into these larger weight classes, strategy changes. The wrestler's a little bit slower, not quite as quick,
but a little more powerful. And when they do something, they do it with authority.
30 seconds to go in the second period. Nice, quick little duck under to a double leg.
All the 138 pounders.
Back to the center, no points.
138 for the press table, please.
Time running down. The fair ball wrestler in the lead, 3-0. Not working hard. Another takedown there for Tim. 5-0 now as Dawson rolls out of it. Choosing not putting his wrestler to the mat.
It looks like they're out of bounds there. No back points.
And that comes just as the period comes to an end. Through with two periods. Tim Tuzignat from Faribault leading 5-0 over Mankato West wrestler David Grousam. So two more minutes to go in this match. Grousam finishing second in the state tournament as a junior last year in the 132-pound division, beaten by Matt Demaray of Apple Valley in the finals. Tuzignat, as a junior, finished third in the 145-pound division. Mark Miley won that division, the Anoka wrestler, and we'll see him coming up next at 155 pounds in a bid to become a two-time state champion.
These men both seem quite confident out here, very much under control. Again, I think that experience is showing up right here.
Time starting to become a factor. 1 minute and 15 seconds to go. 4-point lead for Tuzignat.
Oh, nice
Faribault.
Nice attempt at an arm throw there.
Now 1 minute to go in the match.
Again, Dave's looking there for a throw. He needs big points here. He needs not just a takedown, but he needs to take his opponent down and take him to the mat, right to his back. Point takedown. Nice attempt there by Tim, but it was countered.
We'll pause 5 seconds for stations in the Minnesota High School Wrestling Network to identify themselves.
Pioneer Public TV.
St. Paul Civic Center. An impressive night of wrestling, and we're in the 145-pound division. Faribault's Tim Tuzignat against Mankato West David Grousam. 6-3 our score with 20 seconds to go. The Faribault wrestler in the lead.
Again, Dave looking for that big throw. He's got 10 seconds. He needs to get some big points here if he wants to pull this one out.
10 seconds to go.
Again, very aggressive with that upper body technique there.
Now only 4 seconds. Gold will go to Faribault.
Had a 1 point awarded there to Dave. Stalling against Tim, but it wasn't enough.
His coach Dave Henry up and off the bench to give Tim Tuzignat a round of applause. He beats David Grousam for this 145-pound championship. And the gold medal goes to Southern Minnesota. This time it goes to Faribault.
These co-op tires are covered by...
was only one match, was a three-point match. What do you have going for you in this tournament with your throws?
Well, I've been scouting this guy, and I knew my throws were there, and I've been really working on my throws a lot this year, and I went to a freestyle camp last year. It helped a lot of my throws, and I knew they were there.
Did I see that you were an 11-time state freestyle champion?
Yeah, approximately. I think my dad thinks it's more, but you lose count after 10.
Okay, Corey Olson, fantastic match, a real crowd pleaser. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
State champion from Hayfield, Minnesota. We're going to be back from the Civic Center in St. Paul right after this word. Well.
Yeah, I try to work hard at wrestling and in school.
A big year for you. You beat Matt Demaray earlier in the year. Now, of course, the state title.
I'm really happy with this season. Had a little shaky start up here, but I finished strong.
Tim Tuzignat, a Faribault state champion.
back at a 6-4 semifinal victory over Kevin Ahern of Simley. He'll be wrestling a returning state champion, Mark Miley of Anoka, a senior who's 22-2 on the season, having moved up from 145 where he won the state last year. Miley had a 3-1 semifinal victory over Che Whiteside of Minneapolis Roosevelt in the semifinals.
Jim Skelly and Mike Houck ready for live action in the 155-pound division. Let's go right down to the mat where Mark Miley and Tom Kerpak are going at it. Miley from Anoka, Kerpak from St. Francis.
Kerpak got himself in a little trouble there right off the start. Got taken down and put on his back. He's recovered now. Mark's keeping the pressure on real well.
Miley out to the lead here. Just 40 seconds into this match, 5-0 over Kerpak. These two don't have to go too far. They really didn't have to come to St. Paul to wrestle either, with both right in the same neck of the woods with Anoka and St. Francis. They don't settle it once and for all here. They could always take it up on their own time. Wouldn't take much.
I run into some trouble without referees, though. It's like Mark's got some type of an ankle support there on his... his ankle. Probably has a slight sprained ankle.
Right at the end of his semifinal match, he was grimacing with pain, walking off the mat. At that point, I was wondering if he would be able to compete in the championship, but I guess when you get to this level, you go regardless.
Yep, that's right.
Miley holding on to a lead, 5-1 over Kerpak from St. Francis High School, two of the state's stronger programs. Anoka ranks currently coming into the match second with all-time state champions with 33, only second to Robbinsdale High School, who has 50. They're way out in front. Of course, they're hoping to add to that list tonight with Mark Miley. Ron Malcolm with a long line of successes, success after success at Anoka High School.
Ron Malcolm's been around for a long time. My dad was from Anoka, and Ron Malcolm was around when my dad was in school.
Time is running out here in the first period. Miley holding on to a 5-3 lead over Tom Kerpak. The St. Francis team that Kerpak wrestles for upset the region final by Grand Rapids. I guess it wasn't too much of an upset because the Grand Rapids team was able to move on and advance on to the state finals.
Getting a little advice from his coach there a minute ago, asking what he should do. Coach says take down.
It's again those four new options that a wrestler has. It allows the wrestler to plan his strategy a little bit better. Use his strengths at the time that he wants to.
Good pressure there by Mark. Points.
We have four more matches to go. We're in the 155-pound division. Now you see Miley starting to limp on the mat. That ankle obviously starting to bother him again. It's unfortunate for a returning state champion. Keep in mind, this Mark Miley won the state last year at 145 pounds. I don't know if they're starting to use up some of his injury time now as Coach Malcolm is up and talking with the officials. And now we're ready for more wrestling. Still, there's still plenty of time to go in this match. Miley does not want to default in this one. My guess is that he'll want to stay in the down position as much as possible to keep the pressure off that ankle.
I think so. He's going to need some points here, though. The score's tied up right now. I think... maybe his best strategy right now is to stay down and work on the mat, look for a reversal, keep him off his feet.
Interesting to see if Kerpak goes right after that ankle. Thus far, working on the torso of Miley. We hit the halfway point in this match.
1 point Miley. Escape.
6-5.
Herpak trying to trip on that bum ankle of Miley's. A takedown here would give him the lead. He's trailing 6-5.
We have a position here that's a possible stalemate position.
Nope, not anymore.
What's the referee going to do? Signals a two-point takedown.
7-6 now, Kerpak in the lead. Still time to go here in the match. 20 seconds to go in the second period, so a full 2 minutes after that. And Miley has to be thinking about that ankle.
Yeah, I think so. He's hurting a little bit. And earlier in the match, he went off to the side, and I think he twisted it maybe again a little bit. It looks like it's pretty sore.
Seven to six after two periods, and we'll be back with the third period in this 155-pound match in a moment.
I want her out of that house.
You have to do it within the law. And I'd advise you to do it as discreetly as you possibly can.
Spend too much more time on the feet, I don't think. Right now he's probably looking for a reversal and then looking maybe to ride out his opponent.
So 1 minute to go in this match between Miley and Kerpak. We have a stalling warning. Stalling on the top man. That's a...
Bogley, 5-2.
Put the pressure on Tom Kerpak there. Get some action going. You can see the clock in the upper corner of your screen. Still 1:03 to go. Not over yet. Kerpak in control for much of this match. Much of this third period of this match, rather. What would have to happen now for a stalling point to be awarded?
Well, it would be there's a stalling warning on the bottom man. But for a stalling point to be awarded in the referee's judgment, he would just have to feel that Kerpak was not working hard enough or not working for the fall. The top man, when he's riding, has to work for the fall. He can't just control his opponent and keep him from doing nothing. But he has to continue to be aggressive, continue to try to score points. Both men now have been warned, so another warning on either man means another penalty point. Mark comes up right away.
That's only 171
Miley fighting hard.
Short of the record. 171 short of the record. Thank you for your attendance.
15 seconds to go as the wrestlers leave the mat. Pack trying to upset a defending state champion here.
8 seconds to go.
Kerpak still in control. And he holds on for the championship. So a disappointment for Anoka's Mark Miley. Unable to repeat, but he grimaces as he holds that ankle. Tom Kerpak, the new champion in the 155-pound division.
We promised you we'd be back with a second show on medical imaging, and that's going to be happening this week on Call for Health. Please join Dr. Albert Rui, Dr. Richard Hazen, Dr. Smith, and myself when we take you through the world of Dopplers, CT scans, and digital subtraction angiograms. Sounds complicated, but they're really quite simple and are very useful in diagnosing some of the problems that you may have. So join us Tuesday at 8 p.m. right here on Call for Health.
Paul Civic Center in the 155-pound division, Class A. Darren Kane from Arlington Green Isle wins it. Defeats Rusty Cockleman from Canby. The final score in that match, 4-1. Darren Kane, the new champion in Class A.
Back with more wrestling right after this word.
These co-op tires are covered.
Knocked off a returning champion. Tom, did you think about that much? Did that make any difference to you that he was a returning champion?
A little bit. I figured since he was returning, the pressure was on him because when I was a sophomore, I beat him here the first time, and he was hurt a little bit, so the pressure, he had to be doing a lot of thinking about it.
You came from behind. You were down 5-3 at the end of the first period, and then you gradually came back, and rode him out real strong the last period.
Yeah. He had a bad ankle, so I slowed him down a little bit, so it was a little bit easier to ride him. A real good rest.
Okay, well, that's going to take care of this for Tom Kerpak, our senior AA champion, 155. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
We'll be back with more from the St. Paul Civic Center after this one. This year, I'm just curious, did you have a smile on your face when you came off the mat this time?
Oh, yeah, I felt great. It's been a goal of mine for a long time. Felt real good.
Third place last year, champion this year. Were there any obstacles along the way this season?
Yeah, I got a few injuries. I had mono. I kept coming back and thought hopefully maybe I could come around and place this year. So it's been good.
Got a full summer to get ready for next year again. Congratulations, Darren Kane from Arlington.
Thanks a lot.
We're going to be back with more from the State High School Wrestling Tournament.
SA, Corey Mead of Plainview Elgin Millville, a senior, 32-4 on the season. Mead in the semifinals had a 6-5 victory over Joe Shook of Janesville. He'll be wrestling Peter Fouquet of Maple Lake, a senior who's 32-1. Fouquet had a close 5-4 semifinal victory over Kerry Metz of Beardsley Browns Valley in the semifinals.
Jim Skelly and Mike Houck back watching history in the making here at the 50th annual Minnesota High School Wrestling Tournament. Action on the mat between Maple Lake's Peter Fouquet and Corey Mead from Plainview, Elgin Millville. A pair of seniors out there, and Fouquet, the Maple Lake wrestler, wearing the green tonight. Might be an opportune time to mention, 1 minute to go in this match. Or in the first period, rather. As Fouquet out to the lead. Painesville was the Class A champion. They defeated Plainview, Elgin Millville. So Painesville the champion, they defeat PEM 24-18 for the Class A championship. The Bulldogs' first ever state championship in any sport.
Peter Fouquet, they're looking for that ball, looking for those back points. Doing a good job of working those arm bars. Really keeping the pressure on here real well.
A good look at the concentration on Fouquet's face.
He's controlling that arm. He's keeping the pressure on. And then go off the mat.
They'll move him up to the middle with 2 seconds to go.
Peter's out to an early lead here, doing a good job of controlling.
Fouquet with the lead. We'll take a quick break and be back with more. Long timeout between the periods for Mead to make an adjustment. He may have been scraped up a little bit at the end of that first period.
End of the first period. Choice goes to...
We're going to take a quick break and be back with more in just a moment. Center in the 167-pound division, Corey Mead. Peter Fouquet going at it. The Maple Lake wrestler in the lead. 7-1. Maybe we've only seen one pin in a championship match tonight. That surprises me a little bit, Mike.
It does, yeah.
I guess it doesn't surprise you too much.
No, it doesn't. Again, you know, I think this caliber of wrestling, we see men equally paired in the finals, and you don't see a lot of falls. Apple Valley's Jason Scampiak and Northfield's Craig Kennedy going at it in the AA division.
Corey's doing a pretty good job here riding. He's keeping the pressure on. Peter Fouquet not able to get away. Peter now on his feet. Working for that wrist control. Gets away for one. Increases his lead by a point.
30 seconds to go in the second period. 8-1 now. Peter Fouquet in the lead. Maple Lake with an impressive showing here at the state individuals. They had four entrants. That's a tribute to their program. Now time to mop up things a little bit. Quite a build on both these wrestlers. Fouquet trying to pad his score, up 8-1. 15 seconds to go in the second period.
Pete looking for another opening there to score. A little hand fighting going on. Oh! And Corey got a takedown. 2 points.
8-3 after two periods. Back with more of this 167-pound match in a moment.
For all 150.
He has. Back to the axe again. Peter Fouquet again with an 8-3 lead. Controlling the match well.
Unfortunate thing is that the contract with our Minnesota Wrestling Network expires at 9:30 and all our viewers aren't there. We apologize that we'll have to cut away from the action at that point.
Strandlin 8-2.
And we're in the 167-pound division with 185 and heavyweight to go. Thought for sure we'd be able to get it all in there in that amount of time.
Results.
Match all the non-pins that we'd have. the extra time, each match going the distance, some injuries, and that caused some problems. Slowed it down a little bit, but really a great tribute to Minnesota High School Wrestling to have a meet like this.
That's right. Been a super night of wrestling.
Closing moments of this 167-pound match. Fouquet holding on for Maple Lake. He's leading 8-4. Took a look at the people who helped put this production together tonight. To make a special thank you to Jerry Schmitz, who worked so hard to put this on the air as 1987 tournament. For Mike Houck and Jim Bartels, this is Jim Skelly. Thank you and good evening.